Welcome to Frontier Institute of Medical Sciences, Ahmedabad. Please note the important instructions. You should have a stable internet connection from which you can download this video. Listen to the lecture attentively and carefully and take important notes. On the link below, you can download the notes of this lecture. Complete your assignment and send it to the coordinator. Subscribe the channel and do not forget to click on the bell icon. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you. Dear students, this is a series of online lectures for Master of Public Health program, first semester, basic communication skills. My name is Farooq Yusufzai. Let's move ahead. After this lecture, you will be able to comprehend the concept of communication, discuss and share the importance and objectives of the communication, explain the process of communication, learn about the different types of communication, and you can easily describe the 7 C's of communication. Dear students, what is communication? The word communication is derived from the Latin word communicare, which means to share. Communication refers to a process of exchanging facts, thoughts, beliefs, ideas, or opinions between two or more individuals. The process of communication includes encoding, channeling, and imparting information by a sender to a receiver with the help of a medium. The receiver receives, decodes, and understands the message and sends back the feedback to the sender. This whole process is called communication process. Communication is the most important ingredient of any business. However, small or big, its success depends on how effective its communication system is, whether it is within the organization or outside the organization. Inaccurate or ineffective communication may lead to conflict within the organization and loss of goodwill outside it. Communication skills are prerequisite to personal, academic, and professional success. Effective communication skills help young managers to kickstart their career. In fact, according to a study, the basic skills required at the entry level of today's jobs are communication skills, and this includes all aspects of communication, that is oral, written, and the listening skills. Evening for building good relations. In any professions, you require good interpersonal skills, for which in return you require excellent communication skills. For every profession, communication skills are important, as they help in smooth and effective working of an organization. Good communication skills can enhance your career, personality and you have the confidence to influence and to motivate rather than just command and control. Effective communication can help in achieving organizational success as well, because the satisfaction level of the employees and hence the productivity level multiplies. Even if an individual own effectiveness increases by enhancing communication skills. Thus, it is in the interest of both an individual and an organization. It becomes very important for all to study communication and understand and adopt the various techniques that can help to enhance the productivity of all, thereby looking forward to success. Objectives of communication. Well, students, here we will discuss some important objectives of communication, like to exchange information, to provide active advice and counseling, to issue orders and instructions, to impart education and training, to motivate, to raise morale, to give suggestion, to persuade, and to warn. Now, let's come to the first objective, that is to exchange the information. Dear students, the most important and basic purpose of communication is exchange of information. In an organization, the management needs to keep its employees well informed about their role and responsibility in the organization and about the goals, policies, and rules of the organization. Well-informed employees always perform better, and the environment is also more conducive, so it results in more productivity. Similarly, if an organization communicates effectively with its clients, the clients are more satisfied and organization improves its image in the market. Second objective is to provide advice and counseling. It is the duty of managers or superiors to provide assistance to their subordinates in the task assigned to them. The advice and counseling may be either on official or on personal matters. This becomes important so as to improve the productivity of the subordinates and the organization. The official advice may be related to a particular task or the goals, policies, and rules of the organization. The manager also needs to take that his team members are not under undue stress. Psychological counseling can help the de-stress a person and improve his performance. Now, to issue orders and instructions is the third important objective of communication skills. The order and instructions are based on the authority of the superior, and the subordinate are expected to follow them. These again may be given in a written form or orally as the need may be. But the important fact to remember here is that the orders and instructions always travel downwards in the hierarchical pyramid are one-way flow only. For this, you can relate to Maslow's theory of hierarchy. An important thing to remember is that the orders and instructions should be properly communicated in a clear language to avoid any miscommunication. Number 4, to impart education and training. Well, communication is also used for the purpose of education, the masses. It is also used for educating the masses about the products and services of the organization. Unless the consumers are made aware of the product and services, they will not use them. The price, the quality, the used are some of the important factors that every consumer needs to be made aware of, and this is done through advertisements in the newspapers, magazines, etc. Number 5, to motivate. Motivation activates a person and channelizes his entire energy and attitude towards the attainment of the desired goals. A good manager should know to motivate a team so that he needs not order them to work. Motivated people work harder and perform better. To motivate subordinate, a manager needs effective communication skills, or rather people skills as we call them. An organization can motivate their employees by providing them incentives. Monetary benefits are perhaps the most effective form of motivation. Other ways can be in the form of appreciation awards, even simple praise for outstanding efforts sometimes can increase the productivity of employees. Number 6, to raise morale. High morale and efficient performance go hand in hand. An efficient system of communication helps to boost the morale of the employees. If there is a positive and conducive environment in the organization, the morale of the employees is high. The high morale leads the organization to its desired goals. Care needs to be taken that the policies of the organization do not reflect any negative attitude towards the employees. Upward communication helps to release pent-up emotions and de-stress the employees. And in today's scenario, this is very much required. A healthy environment minus negative approach and minus rumors helps in organizations to move ahead towards its desired goals. Number 7, to give suggestions. Good ideas on a subject may come from all working in an organization. It is usually observed that suggestion boxes are maintained in the organizations these days. This is actually improving the upward communication and letting the employees know that their opinion also matters. Obviously, this leads to a motivated and happy team of employees, and thus the organization and its productivity increases and grows. Number 8, to persuade. Persuasion means to influence the beliefs and attitude of others. The success of any business depends on the art of selling of its services and products. Persuasion is an art which everyone needs to excel at. Good communication skills, both oral and written, are helpful in developing good persuasion skills. Number 9. To warn. Even though harsh, but warning is an objective of communication. It may involve warning subordinates on account of their misbehavior, negligence, defiance of rules, and lack of punctuality or any other action on the part of the employees which could harm the organization or its reputation or image in the business world. Well, students, this was something about the objectives of the organization, communication. So, in a good organization, if you want to do effective communication, you have to meet all these objectives to make an organization successful communication-wise, and also increase and enhance the level of productivity. Dear students, as we studied or discussed in the very first instance, that communication is a two-way process. It involves senders and the receivers. The communication process consists of six basic elements. That are encoding message, decoding the message, receiver and feedback. The process of communication is shown in the figure. These are known as the elements of communication. These are sender, encoding, message, decoding, receiver and feedback. Now, let's discuss the elements of communication. As you can see, now what is sender? Sender refers to a party or agent who sends the intended message to another party or agent. Sender is also known as a source in the process of communication. What is encoding? Encoding refers to a process that puts the thoughts in a framework of symbol or words. What is a message? The message refers to the collection of symbols or words that together convey the intention of the sender. The message is sent by the sender to the receiver. Decoding. It refers to the process of deciphering the received message and understanding its intended meaning. Now, who is the receiver? Receiver refers to a party or agent who receives the sent message. The receiver is also known as the audience or destination in the process of communication. Now, feedback, it refers to the response of the receiver to the message of the sender. This part of communication process establishes a two-way communication between the receiver and the sender. It can be an acknowledgement of receiving the message or reply of the message. This is communication process. Dear students, let's discuss the types of communication. In an organization, communication can be categorized on the basis of the channels used, direction of information flow, and the means used to communicate. Managers issue orders and instructions to employees to enable them to carry out their work effectively and efficiently. This form of communication is formal. Sometimes informal communication also takes place among the individuals in the organization due to superior to subordinate, subordinate to the superior, or between the supervisors and at the same level as well. Apart from this, an organization also communicates. Now, if we see the types of communication, we discussed three means of communication. Number one, on the basis of channels used, which includes formal and informal communication. Second, on the basis of the direction used, that which includes upward communication, downward communication, horizontal communication, and diagonal communication. And the third important one is on the basis of the means used for communication. It includes verbal, non-verbal, written, and visual communication. Now, let's discuss the different types of communication on the basis of the channels used. Formal communication. This type of communication occurs in a formal pattern that is acceptable in an organization. It involves meetings, conferences, corporate letters, and written memos within the organization. The formal communication can take place between two strangers at the time of first meeting. So, the formal communication follows a straightforward, rigid, precise, and official approach. Now, informal communication. Informal communication includes a free and uninhibited communication between two agents, parties, or people who share a rapport with each other. Such communication needs to two people who have same wavelengths or common interests. It involves communication between friends, family members. This type of communication is not based on any rigid rule or guidelines and does not have any restriction of time or place. Online chats and long telephonic talks are the example of informal communication. So this was on the basis of channel used. Now, on the basis of direction. On the basis of direction, we have upward communication. It refers to the flow from the lower level to upper level of organization hierarchy. For example, when an employee makes a request or communicates the idea to the senior, upward communication encourages the active participation of employees in the function of their department. Downward communication. It refers to the flow from upper level to the lower level. For example, when a superior issues orders and instructions to subordinate. When A general manager passes orders to the supervisors. The flow of communication is downward. It includes new policy through official statement, memos, reports, speeches, notices, and meetings. Horizontal communication. It refers to the communication taking place among the members at the same level in the organization. For example, a marketing manager may communicate the marketing plan to the production manager. The flow of communication between the individuals at the same position. Now, diagonal communication. It refers to the communication that takes place between individuals in different departments and at different levels of organizational hierarchy. Diagonal communication takes place under particular circumstances. For example, a diagonal communication takes place when a head of a department at one branch of a bank communicates with a cashier of the other branch of the same bank. This was about the communication on the basis of direction. Dear students, now we will discuss communication on the basis of means. Verbal communication. Verbal communication takes place with the help of sounds, words, and language. The various languages spoken throughout the world have been originated from a number of sound and gestures. It is an integral part of communication that involves people belonging to different cultures, ages, and races. This communication involves the act of speaking, which is an effective way of communication, also known as public speaking. It is classified in the types interpersonal communication and public speaking. Now, what is interpersonal communication? This type of verbal communication takes place between two or more people, generally at the personal level. And public speaking involves single speaker and many audience. The second type, on the basis of means, is non-verbal communication. Non-verbal communication refers to the kind of communication that involves various characteristics such as tone of the voice, which is also known as inflection, tone of the voice, smell, touch, and body motions. It may have symbol and sign languages that do not require words to be conveyed. For example, finger on lips is a sign of telling the other person to be silent. It involves also body postures and gestures. It is said that words may be false, however, body language conveys a true message. A very important part of communication or type of communication is written communication on the basis of means. Written communication involves the use of emails, articles, reports, and memos. For business purpose, it can be used in different languages depending on the location and language of an organization. So, the written document needs to be edited a number of times before it is conveyed to the intended individual of the organization. It may also be used for the purpose of informal communication, for example, SMS. Visual communication. It involves the visual display of information, such as photos, formats, signs, codes, symbols, and designs. For example, television, DVDs, and other audio-visual aids of communication represents this type of communication. So these are the means or the types of communications that are carried out on the basis of channels, directions, and means. Dear students, now we will discuss an important part of communication, which is also known as grapevine communication. What is grapevine communication? As you can see in the picture, this picture speaks a lot about the grapevine communication. Grapevine communication travels in every direction without any particular restrictions. Some have also named it as rumor mill. A message spreads like wildfire almost instantaneously as soon as it enters the grapevine. The channel, even though it is unofficial, are created and controlled by the people themselves. There are some factors that leads to the grapevine. There may be a feeling of uncertainty among the employees when the organization is passing through a difficult phase. Sometimes lack of self-confidence in an employee is the cause of grapevine. Sometimes sycophancy prevails in the organization and favored group is formed, giving others a feeling of insecurity that gives to their pent-up feelings through the grapevine. Now, there are some chains of this communication system. Let's discuss some important chains. These are single strand chain, gossip chain, probability chain, cluster chain. Now, single strand chain is the one in which A, for example, A passes a piece of information to the B, who passes it to the C, and so on and so on. This is single strand chain system. The second chain is gossip chain. Gossip chain is formed when a person, for example A, seeks out everyone around him and passes the information to all. The third one is probability chain. It is a random kind of chain where information is conveyed according to the law of probability. Number fourth is the cluster chain. It is formed when a person, for example A, tells a piece of information to a selection number of people who in turn pass it on to another group of selected people. So this is something about the four important chains of grapevine system. Now, what are the advantages and disadvantages of this system of communication? Social relations are built and the grapevine provides a high amount of psychological satisfaction to the employees. People come closer to each other and this builds organizational solidarity. The speed at which the messages are transmitted in this system are unbelievable. Since all information cannot be sent across by official channels, therefore, the grapevine is used to supplement the official to transmit information. Feedback is also reaches the management very fast through the grapevine. This feedback can be useful to the organization. Dear students, on the other hand, there are some disadvantages of this communication system. For example, distortion of the news is the major disadvantage of this system. This channel of communication respects nobody and can destroy the image of even the noblest of the people. Rumor is the untrue part of this system. Personal motives are usually dominant in the spread of news through this system. Incomplete information is sometimes transmitted through the grapevine and thus a person cannot get a complete picture of any issue. Lack of authenticity is there in the news traveling through the grapevine as it is spread by word of mouth and there are no tangible facts to support the news. Now, how can we use this system to the best of the organization? Dear students, to use this system effectively, the manager needs to understand that the grapevine cannot be ignored and it will neither die nor wither, and also it can have a damaging effect. Therefore, it is in the interest of the organization that the manager learns to use the grapevine effectively for the benefit of the organization. Rumors should be contradicted promptly and not wait till the harm is done. A manager should keep his ears and eyes open and try to spot the leaders and win their confidence. The management should let the employees be a part of the decision-making process as far as possible. This helps the employee to feel like being a part of the family. Every manager needs to adopt an open door policy and maintain a healthier environment. A manager needs to be a good empathetic listener so that the employee feels free to talk to him rather than indulge in rumor mongering. The organization is the source of bread and butter for its employees, and nobody would like to harm the source if respect and dignity of all is maintained. Harmful rumors would automatically come to an end, and a grapevine could be cultivated. The manager should use the grapevine for feedback and even try to improve any shortcomings that may be therein, as well as in the management. Using the grapevine effectively can improve the true productivity of the organization. Therefore, the managers should learn to do so. Dear students, now we discuss about the 7 C's of communication. This is a very hot topic. A communication can be called effective if the receiver understands the intended meaning conveyed by the sender. For a business communication to be effective, it should have 7 qualities, or the 7 C's are principles of effective communication. These are clarity, completeness, conciseness, consideration, correctness, concreteness, and courtesy. Dear students, let's discuss the 7 C's one by one. Number 1, clarity. Clarity requires that a simple language should be used in communication. Moreover, the communication should be clear enough so that the receiver can easily understand the message of the sender. Conveying clear information enables the receiver to read the mind of the sender with an ease. One should keep in mind the following points to convey a clear message. Objectives of the message to be conveyed. Length, simplicity, and relevancy of the sentences. Suitable medium to convey the message. The targeted receiver, that is the top level, medium level, or lower level of the organizational hierarchy. Use of examples, illustrations, and visual aids. Second is completeness. It implies that communication should contain all the necessary information to get the desirable response from the sender. On the other hand, the sender should answer all the questions asked by the receiver and pay attention to all minute details. This leads to effective communication, which results in accomplishment of predefined goals. If the communication is not complete, it can result into misinterpretation of information by the sender or receiver. Following points should be taken into consideration while checking for completeness of communication. These are answering all the asked questions, conveying relevant data, extra details when desirable. However, the details should be relevant. Checking for the 5 W's. These 5 W's are what, when, where, why, and who. Number 3 is conciseness. Well, it implies that the message should be free from superfluous details, which helps in saving the time of both the sender and the receiver. Moreover, to make the communication effective, one should avoid wordy expression and repetitions. However, making the message concise does not aim at losing the completeness of the message. Consideration. Consideration requires preparing the message, keeping the recipient in mind. A sender, while sending the message, should take into consideration the views, thoughts, backgrounds, mindset, and education level of the receiver, and vice versa. A considerate message should have the following features: laying focus on you approach, that is keeping the receiver on sender's place, show interest in the sender while sending the message. This helps in receiving the positive response from the sender. Correctness. It implies that the message should state accurate facts and figures. Moreover, one should use the right level of language. In addition, the message should be free from grammar, spelling, and punctuation errors in particular. Correctness. Well, correctness implies that the message should be specific and to the point. The details provided in the message should be definite and vivid. One should avoid using vague and obscure statement in the message. The last one is courtesy. It is one of the most important element of an effective communication. One should use polite words in the message and should be appreciative, thoughtful, and tactful while receiving or sending a message. Dear student, this was about the basic communication skills. We discussed the basic concepts of communication, importance of objectives of the communication, the process of communication, types of communication, and 7 C's of communication. Now, you have to write the assignments and send it to the Frontier Institute of Medical Sciences, Ahmedabad coordinator. For details, you can contact on the numbers stated here. So the assignment is, what is communication, and explain the process of communication. Second, how moral of implies can be raised by effective communication. Number third, what is upward communication and how it is different from downward communication. Number fourth is, what is grapevine communication? What are the factors leading to this system of communication? Non-courtesy communication leads to what kind of misunderstanding? So all you have to do is to write your assignments in clear writing and send it accordingly. Thank you so much for joining. Stay safe and stay home. Thank you.